guys, it's SimmerDeb. Welcome to part 22 of Let's Play The Sims 4 Killer Instinct. In the last episode, Aiden killed his most recent wife, Nancy Landgrab. Now, Aiden has chosen Zoe Patel to be his next wife and the next victim. But in order to marry her and take her simoleons, he must murder all the other members of Zoe Patel's household. And previously, he had tried to kill Gavin Richards by setting Gavin's bed on fire while Gavin was sleeping. However, Zoe's other roommate, J Huntington, decided to be a hero and he burst into the rooms and put the fire out before Gavin could die. And this made Aiden so mad he couldn't hardly stand it. So Aiden vowed that J Huntington would be the first of Zoe's roommates to die. And now, currently, they are at the gym. Aiden invited J Huntington out to the gym and said, you know, let's get to know each other better. Let's go and have a workout. So here they are at the gym. And Aiden now has J Huntington trapped in the bathroom alone. J went in there to the bathroom and Aiden followed him. And what Aiden has planned is, Aiden is going to make J Huntington's death look like a very unfortunate electrocution by natural causes. He's going to rig up some of the wiring with the light switch in the bathroom and make sure that it looks like that is what killed J Huntington. When in actuality, Aiden is going to use his electrocution device that looks like a hand buzzer and acts like a hand buzzer to actually murder J Huntington. So, he's going to just talk to him for just a few minutes. And, you know, make sure that J stays off guard and doesn't suspect anything. Oh, well. I kind of thought J was already through doing what he was doing, but I guess not. I didn't know this was going to happen, but, you know, that's just one of those things that happens in The Sims 3, but I guess two guys, it's probably not quite as embarrassing if, you know, if it was a girl that he walked in on, but let's just see if he even is embarrassed at all. Nope, he's not. I guess they're good enough friends so that, it doesn't matter. you know, Jay can just be on the pot and, you know, so what? But, you know, Aiden knows that he really doesn't have that much of a reason to be embarrassed because Jay's not going to be alive long enough for it to really be on his mind. And you know what? I think... Okay, wait a minute. All right, now that he's finished, he's going to let him have it with the hand buzzer. Oh no! J Huntington is being electrocuted. And of course Aiden has to pretend like he's really upset and really cares about it. And I don't even really see anybody else in the gym. Now when we left off at the last part, this gym was packed. But it is 2:30 in the morning, so I guess that has something to do with it. I don't know who this guy is. This is Cameron Dooley. I don't think we've met him. But anyway, Aiden, there's nobody around to even know, you know, whether you're pretending to cry or not. And you, Aiden already has a good enough relationship with the Grim Reaper, you know, that Grim knows what Aiden's up to. Grim is no dummy. He knows. So we're just going to go ahead and take that morning moodlet off of him and let him be himself. He's actually on a roll and feeling playful. And I don't really know, you know, why he's still crying. And I've told him to go here, but I don't think he can get there because he can't step over poor J. Huntington's body. And we'll just go ahead and look and see. J. Huntington is the 14th victim who Aiden has murdered. So he's getting pretty good at murdering now. It's getting on up there. He's going to go ahead and see how Mr. Grim Reaper's doing. see how his day is going, brighten his day, and just get to improve their relationship even more. They're already, I do believe that the Grim Reaper is Aiden's best friend. Let's just look and see. Yeah, he's got, you know, his friendship level with Grim Reaper is higher than anybody else. He's got a pretty good friendship level with Zoe right now. And he had a pretty good friendship level with Jay, whom he just murdered. Oh, Blaine. Blaine, I guess, is Aiden's best friend. He's doing pretty good with Bella, too. Which I think he's going to probably want to go over and see Bella. But right now, poor Aiden is hungry because murdering Sims, you know, it can give you quite an appetite. Takes quite a bit out of you and makes you quite hungry. So, he's going to go ahead and run home now and get himself a little something to eat. And I'm going to have to pause while I'm on the loading screen and take care of my real-life puppy dog, and I will be right back. Okay, guys, sorry about that interruption. But I am back, and Aiden is home, and he is hungry, and he's going to go ahead and grab himself a little something to eat. And then he plans to go over. What time is it? It's 5 o'clock in the morning, and I don't know if Zoe Patel would be awake or not, but I'm going to make him go ahead and clean that up. He was going to go play his video game, but not right now. And Aiden is feeling very, very happy. What's he doing? He's putting away books and kind of cleaning the house and going to the bathroom, washing his hands, and now I'm going to have him go over. He's going to go over and just see how Zoe Patel's doing and maybe see if her other roommates are at home. He's not really sure who's going to be next on his list. We've got Gavin Richards, and I don't remember the name of the other roommate, but the other roommate, I've noticed he is very angry all the time and kicks over his own trash every time he turns around. And I don't really know what's up with that. And I see him. That's the angry guy right there. It looks like he's dancing. And Aiden's just going to go on ahead and, yep, he's dancing. Getting down with his own bad self. And where's Miss Zoe Patel? Is she even home? You know, it would be really great if Zoe was not home. There's Gavin. Oh, they're all three home. All right. Well, you know, the best thing for Aiden to do is probably to divide and conquer. Let's talk to this guy a little bit and discuss interests with him. You know, and poor Zoe. Aiden almost, but not quite, feels a little bit sorry for Zoe Patel because she's such a sweet girl. You know, she's kind of innocent, actually. So he kind of feels a little bit sorry for her, but not enough to stop his plan, you know. He's got to have those simoleons, you know. Got to have them. And he doesn't really trust any woman, even if they do act sweet and innocent the way Zoe Patel acts. He's wondering if there's not something going on below the surface that's not apparent that, you know, makes her not quite as sweet as what she, you know, appears to be. Aiden really wishes that, I wonder if, he's wondering if either one of these people have a job, and it's kind of hard to ask them. I think Gavin might have a job. I don't know about, what is this guy's name? This guy's Mitchell Kalani. That's his name. And Aiden just walked right through him. Well, while Aiden is here, he probably needs to talk to Zoe a little bit and make sure that, you know, they're still on track in their relationship, because it's been a while since he's seen Zoe, since he spent any real time with her. He's gonna go ahead and talk with her. And you know what? The last two or three times we've been over here, Zoe has been in her pajamas. So I don't know what's up with that, but you know, I don't know if she just stays in her pajamas all day or what's up with that, but she's always in her pajamas. Maybe she just, when she sees Aiden coming, she sees him coming through the window and she goes and changes into her pajamas really quick so that, you know, he'll spend some time in the bedroom with her. Maybe that's what it is. I don't know. Just don't know at all. But they're just going to kind of, you know, make their relationship a little bit better. Okay, good. Now, it looks as though Gavin is chatting with Aiden pretty well. Now, Aiden does not what is Gavin saying? Gavin's probably talking about going on a rocket ship and, you know, having woohoo and rocket ship or something is kind of what that heart rocket ship looks like. I don't know. I don't know if Gavin is an astronaut. He could be. I'm not really sure. Aiden's going to go ahead and brighten his day and talk with him a little bit. Aiden is going to try to lure Gavin outside because, you know, Aiden has not forgotten that he... Hey, I thought they had a barbecue grill back here. They don't have a barbecue grill? Huh. Well, that's not good. That's not fair at all. I thought they had a barbecue grill. Well, let's see. Aiden is wanting to lure Gavin somewhere where he can, you know, possibly set a small house fire and engulf Gavin in the flames of the house fire. Okay, now.
Nora Zakuni. Jord Rinka.
Let's see if we can't, you know, get Gavin to come a little bit closer to that stove. Maybe if Aiden, you know, just keeps backing up a little bit. Maybe, you know, Gavin might come a little bit closer to that stove. I don't know. Don't know if this is going to work or not. He's going to discuss the latest video games with Gavin. Gavin!
Taringa.
Let's try this one more time. Go here to Gavin. He's like, Gavin, come here. I want to talk to you about something that I saw in your kitchen. And let's just see if Gavin will follow. No. Come here, Gavin. I want to show you something. Ah! Yes. Now. Aiden knows that this stove might look like an electric stove, but it's actually a gas-burning stove. Okay? So, therefore, Aiden has decided to take a match and turn the gas. No, that would explode. Aiden has decided to set the stove on fire, okay? And we'll just see what happens. Now, this Aiden's standing pretty close to this fire, so it's very possible that Aiden might get a little bit singed himself. But he's going to try to burn up Gavin with this stove. He's going to try to set the stove on fire and just see if he can get Gavin in the process. Think it'll work? I don't know. It seems a little bit risky to me because Aiden's a little bit close to this fire, but let's go and see what happens. Oh, it didn't even get... Oh, it did get him! And look, he's going to be a hero too. Mitchell Kalani. I'm telling you what, Zoe lives in a house full of heroes, you know? So I don't know what to say about that. But Aiden, he needs to run out there and get away from this fire. Watch him run right through the fire. Okay, Aiden got out. Now, is he going to be able to put out Mitchell? Or is Mitchell going to die this time? I don't know. Mitchell's still on fire. And not Mitchell. Gavin is still on fire. And Mitchell's just standing there looking at him. So, you know, what this tells me is that Mitchell didn't want his precious stove to get destroyed. But when it comes to Gavin Richards, Mitchell does not like Gavin Richards. Mitchell wants Gavin to, you know. Oh, and Aiden was going to go dance. Okay, Aiden, if you want to go dance, you just go right ahead, my friend. So what this tells me is that Mitchell doesn't care if Gavin burns to death or not. You know, he's just going to walk away and go over there and dance with Aiden. Oh, no, look at Gavin. I think Gavin is not long for this world. Oh, no, Gavin cannot put out the fire. And Zoe has no idea that Gavin's on fire. Oh, no. Mitchell just let poor Gavin burn. And Aiden's over there just laughing and dancing up and having a really good time. He just can't believe his luck. He can't believe how lucky he got that Mitchell did not care enough about Gavin to put poor Gavin's fire out. And there he goes. Poor Gavin is collapsing on the kitchen floor. And Gavin has died. And now Aiden is coming over saying, oh, look, y'all. Gavin was on fire, and now he's dead. Why did you not put him out, Mitchell? You had the fire extinguisher. And Zoe's like, yeah, Mitchell. Why didn't you put out Gavin? You put the stove out. Had to save your precious stove. Didn't want to lose any simoleons to replace that stove. But, you know, who cares about poor Gavin? You just let him burn to a crisp. And Aiden's saying, way to go, Mitchell. Good deal, buddy. You know, I thought there was something up with Mitchell. You know, he is always angry all the time and always kicking over that trash can. And Grim's like, Aiden, didn't I just see you earlier today at the gym? And Aiden's like, well, yeah. I think you did. And there he goes. Poor Gavin Richards is dead. We're going to go ahead and put him in Aiden's inventory. Victim number 15, Gavin Richards. And Aiden has got quite a collection of tombstones or urns, whatever you want to call them. And they're just having a good old time. He's chatting with Zoe. Now he's going to go and take himself a nap, it looks like. And he was having a boring discussion. I guess that was the one with Gavin. He's just going to go over there and catch a few Z's, and we'll just speed through this a little bit. Another thing that Aiden wanted to do, he wanted to go over and visit Bella Goth, because he and Bella Goth, you know, they have become pretty good friends. And he's just kind of wondering what Bella's current situation is. He knows she's got kids. He doesn't know how old they're getting to be. And he's having a very unpleasant conversation with Mitchell. You know what? I bet you Mitchell probably has some kind of bad trait, and that's why he's angry all the time. I don't know. And there, Grim's going to watch some television. Well, Aiden has had enough of this scene. He's going to go ahead and head over to Bella Goth's house and just, you know, see if she's at home. I think she lives here. Come on, game. Yep. He's going to run over there for a little while and see what Miss Bella's up to and kind of get the lowdown on her family situation. He's thinking that she has a son who is a child who may have grown up into a teen by now. And, you know, if he decided to make Bella a victim, he would probably get stuck with raising her teenage kid for a little while, but, you know, it probably wouldn't be for very long. And there's Bella, you know, and she's out doing push-ups in her low-cut dress. Now, I don't know if she's trying to entice Aiden or what, but how many women do you know go out in high heels in a low-cut red dress and do their push-ups? You know, I don't know. I don't know how many women do that. But Bella Goth does. That's the norm for her, I guess. Uh-huh. And so Aiden's just going to stand inside this little fencing here and talk to Bella for a moment. And is there not supposed to be landscaping inside that fencing? I don't know. It looks kind of odd for that fencing to be there with nothing in it, but whatever. And there's one of Bella's kids. Aiden was going to go ahead and knock on the door, just see who all's at home. Is she? I wonder if she's still a teen or if she's a young adult now. Cassandra Goth is. So that's okay, here we go. This looks like her son here. And he is now a teen. So that's good news. So Aiden is just going to go inside and kind of introduce himself to Bella's family. Just get to know them just a wee bit and see how they're doing. And Cassandra needs a makeover. She's now that she's a young adult, thinks she needs a new hairdo and, you know, some new clothes. He's going to go over here and just introduce himself to Bella's kids. He's going to give Cassandra a cheerful introduction.
Jim Whipsy.
He's going to, I don't know if he knows Mortimer or not. He does not. He's going to give Mortimer a cheerful introduction as well. And also introduce himself to Alexander. And they look like a nice, happy family giving each other hugs. And Aiden is just kind of casing the joint, looking around the place as the trolley goes by. The trolley you can never catch, that you can never ride. He's just going to kind of case the joint a little bit and just go ahead and see what's up here and just kind of see what's what and where everything is and, you know, stuff of that nature. Hint, hint. Nudge, nudge. And now he's got to do his push-ups because, you know, that's what he does when he has just had a successful day of murdering. It makes him feel so energized that he just wants to do his push-ups and he wants to go and clean up their house by putting their book away. And I don't know why he looks kind of sad. Why is he looking sad? I don't know. He doesn't have anything in his... Look at him putting away the books. I don't know what's up with that. But, you know, that's what I do. When I go over to someone's house that I hardly know, I start cleaning up, don't you? But anyway, that's what he's doing. He's going to talk to Bella just a little bit more and see if he can't, you know... Get his relationship. Oh, she just threw her husband there. She's flirting with her husband. How sweet. He's going to go ahead and compliment her outfit a little bit. He's just going to be friendly with her. It looks like they're pretty good friends already. He's going to talk about logic puzzles. And he's also going to flatter her a little bit. And he's going to express his admiration to her. And he's also going to flirt with her right here in front of her husband and see what she does. Just a flirt. Nothing heavy. Let's just see how Mortimer reacts. Let's just see how Bella reacts. And Bella, she has her back turned to him, but she seems like she kind of might have flirted back just a wee little bit. So he's going to do it again right here in front of her husband and her kid and see what happens. You know, Aiden has a way with the ladies. Yeah, she's flirting back. And Mortimer doesn't seem like he even notices what's going on. He's going to ask her if she's single, although he knows better. He knows she's married to Mortimer, but he's going to go ahead and compliment her appearance, too. And he's just going to do some little flirty flirts. He's going to give her a pickup line. And, you know, nobody seems to mind. Aiden has reached level 7 of the charisma skill. He can now ask Sims for a small loan or to repay a loan. And he's just going to keep on flirting with Bella because, you know, it looks like she doesn't really care whether her husband sees her flirt with him or not. He's going to blow her a kiss even.
And it preps too late.
I don't know. She might be shutting him down now. Let's just see if he's gotten the embarrassed moodlet. No, he doesn't. He's got a deep connection. Building strong relationships with others is cause for happiness. Oh, and she's talking about money. And simoleons are Aiden's very favorite subject in the whole wide world. He's going to give her a kiss and see what happens. He's like, yeah, I'm slick, and I'm just going to kiss you right here in your living room right in front of your husband. And she kissed him back. And Mortimer's like, yeah, so what? And Aiden's like, well, show me your upstairs, Bella. And they have this nice, beautiful red bed up here. They're going to go and sit together for a little while. Aiden's just going to see how far he can push this because he's like, well, if you don't care, I don't care. And if he can get, you know, some kind of relationship going with Bella, then, you know, there's one more that he can seduce down the line. But he's not really sure how he feels about Alexander being a teenager. He took on raising Blaine. He's not really sure if he wants to go through that again with another kid.
Avinor?
He doesn't know. But at the same time, there's no way in the world that he would ever murder a teenager. I mean, he has no real scruples. But, you know, there's Alexander right there. Maybe we shouldn't have done this, but Alexander has just seen his mother make out with another man. What is Alexander going to do? Is he just going to stand there and do nothing? It looks like he's going to stand there and do nothing. And Aiden's like, well, you know, why not just have a little fun? Have a little rompy romp, a little woody hoo. Your son doesn't seem to mind. Okay, she shut that down. But, you know, it's like, her son is right here. Okay, now let's just see if she'll woody hoo with him. Bella, oh, Bella, darling. And Aiden looks so sad. I don't really understand why Aiden is sad. He has no sad moodlets at all. Don't really know. You know, maybe this life of murder is starting to get to him just a little bit. Not because he cares about the people he's murdering, but maybe it's just exhausting, an exhausting way of life. You know, you have that adrenaline rush from the murder, and then after that adrenaline rush is over, you feel kind of exhausted, perhaps. Maybe that's what he's feeling, but he does appear to be a little bit down, a little bit sad, so we're probably going to have to see if we can fix that. It might be because he's got the in the presence of death moodlet. That's it. Okay, so they're in here doing a wooty hooty hoo, and I don't know where Mortimer is, but Bella just, she doesn't seem to mind at all, so... You know, Aiden says, if you don't mind, honey, I don't mind. You know, whatever. That's what Aiden says. Aiden's like, well, you know. So Aiden has decided, and look at there, he's kissing her without me even telling him to. He's hungry and he needs a shower. And, you know, he's helped himself to Mortimer's wife. So he thinks he's just going to go ahead and help himself to Mortimer's shower and Mortimer's food as well. And Mortimer's just in there with his kids. And, you know, let's just look at Alexander. I don't think Alexander has said a word to Mortimer about what he saw his mother do. And, you know, I'm pretty sure Mortimer saw Aiden kiss Bella. I don't know. Don't know what's up with that. And Aiden thinks the whole thing is kind of strange. Because if Aiden was married to someone, and he saw, he's going to go ahead and cook a gourmet meal while he's here. He's going to go ahead, let's go ahead and just have pasta primavera. He'll go ahead and make a party size so that they can have something to eat when he leaves. But anyway, like I was saying, Aiden finds the whole situation rather odd because Aiden knows that he never loved any of the women that he was married to, okay? However, if he had ever seen any one of those women kiss another man, there would have been H-E double hockey sticks to pay, okay? There really would have been hell to pay. whoever he saw kiss his wife, they would not have lived very long. Because, you know, that's just the kind of guy that Aiden is. Not because he loved the women, but, you know, it's just the whole point of them being your wife. So Aiden doesn't have a clue what's up with Mortimer Goff and Vela Goff. He does not know what kind of relationship the Goffs have. But he knows it's strange, whatever it is. And what was that? That was a garden salad. He's going to go ahead and just call everybody down here and say, come and eat, guys. I have made you a feast. What are you doing? He's going to put that plate down and get another plate,
cool.
Right?
You are.
Is that what he's going to do? No, he's just going to stand up and eat. Well, that's fine. Okay. And with that, guys, I'm going to have to say goodbye because my time is up. But thank you all so very, very much for watching this very unusual episode of Killer Instinct. I hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did enjoy it, please let me know in the comments down below. Please leave me a like and please subscribe. See you next time.